Hello students, 12 on the topic first law of thermodynamics by Professor Prashant S. Shedwalkar, Mechanical Engineering Department, VSM's SRKIT Nippani. So in the previous class, we have studied first law of thermodynamics for open system, and also we have studied a steady flow energy equation and the applications of steady flow energy equation in the steam turbine and in the air compressors we have studied. So now we'll solve some problems based on the steady flow energy equation. The working fluid in a steady flow process flows at a rate of 220 kg per minute. The fluid rejects 100 kilojoules per second of heat passing through the system. The conditions of the fluid at the inlet and outlet are given as velocity 320 meters per second, pressure P1 is 6 bar, and internal energy U1 is 2000 kilojoules per kg, specific volume 0.36 meter cube per kg, and velocity 140 meters per second. This is for outlet, and pressure P2 1.2 bar, U2 is 1400 kilojoules per kg, specific volume 1.3 meter cube per kg. Now this suffix 1 and 2 indicates the condition at the inlet and outlet. Determine the power capacity of the system in megawatt. The change in potential energy is neglected. So this question has asked in the January 2017 for 8 marks. Same question has repeated in the June 2009 also. See here, mass flow rate he has given 220 kg per minute. So we have to convert it in SI, that is kg per second. So 220 divided by 60 we have done here, 3.6 is kg per second. So heat is rejected here, so minus 100 kilojoules per second or kilowatt. This heat is rejected here, it is minus. So potential energy is neglected, Z1 is equal to Z2 we will consider here. That is nothing but 0 only. So as per steady flow process, M1 dot will be equal to M2 dot will be equal to M only. So let me write the equation, steady flow energy equation first. Q is equal to m dot h2 minus h1 plus 1 upon 2 v2 square minus v1 square plus this g into z2 minus z1 plus w. So this we will neglect here. Already he has told in the problem, potential energy is neglected. So Q is equal to m dot. So h equation we are having h, but this enthalpy value he has not given. So this enthalpy I can write in terms of internal energy and pressure and volume terms. So H2E is nothing but U2 plus P2 V2 because we are not having enthalpy value. So I have convert this enthalpy in this form. U2 plus P2 V2 minus H1 is nothing but U1 plus P1 V1 plus this equation as it is. So this will be anyhow 0 plus W dot. So Q is minus 100. Minus 100 we have substituted. Mass flow rate is 3.667. So U2 already he has given these values, 1400 plus pressure he has given in bar. We are converting it in kilonewton per meter square or kilopascal. So specific volume he has given minus U1 value. This also he has given 6 bar. We have converted it in kilopascal into specific volume he has given plus 1 upon 2. V2 also he has given velocity. V1 also he has given plus 9.81. This term is 0. So anyhow this will be 0 only plus W dot. So he has asked us to calculate the work done per unit time only, minus 100. So if we will solve this entire equation, so this will be minus 2572.03 plus W dot. So therefore W dot will be equals to 2472 kilowatt or 2.472 megawatt. Next problem we'll see here. The fluid properties at the entry are 5 bar, 50 meters per second and 0.78 meter cube per kg, and the corresponding properties at the exit are 1 bar, 100 meters per second, 0.97 meter cube per kg. Full point. The inlet is 5 meter above the exit and the internal energy at the entry is greater than that of the exit by 119 kilojoules. Find the output work. You can see here द इनलेट इज 5 मीटर अबव द एग्जिट, दैट मीन्स 5 Z1 इज 5 मीटर ग्रेटर दैन द Z2. सिमिलरली इंटरनल एनर्जी एट द एंट्री इज ग्रेटर दैन दैट ऑफ द एग्जिट, दैट इज U1 विल बी इक्वल्स टू U2 प्लस 119. So Z1 will be also equals to Z2 plus 5. The meaning is that only here. You can see here. You can see here. Q is heat is flowing out of the device. Definitely it will be minus only, minus 25 kilojoules. Pressure P1 is given in bar. We have converted it in kilopascal. Velocity V1 given 50 meters per second. Specific volume he has given. Where Z1 is equals to 5 meter. It is above the exit level. When Z2 is 0, then easily I can write Z1 is equals to 5 meter. Similarly, internal energy is greater than 119 kilojoules than the exit. So U1 will be equals to U2 plus 119 kilojoules. We can write here. Similarly, these all values he has given in the problem. So therefore, Q dot will be equals to M dot. So U2 plus P2 V2 minus U1 plus P V1. This is the steady flow energy equation. So let us substitute all the values here in this equation. Minus 25 for a kg of fluid. M he has given 1. So U2 we have U2 minus U1. It is U2 minus U1 is nothing but minus 119 from this equation. I have substituted here. P2 he has given V2 minus P1 V1 I have substituted here. Plus 1 upon 2 V2 and V1 also he has given into 10 to the power minus 3. We have done here. Plus G is 9.81 into Z2 is 0 minus Z1. We have converted it in into 10 to the power minus 3 plus W dot here. So minus 25, if we will simplify this equation, we are going to get minus 408.3 plus W dot. So minus 25 minus 408.3 plus W dot. Therefore W dot will be equals to 383.3 joules. So this is the work done here.